Image. A young girl with pink eyeglasses sits at a desk in a classroom. She is using a blue Braille writer. Text on screen reads, No Limits, AFB, American Foundation for the Blind, expanding possibilities for people with vision loss. Helen Keller Lesson Plans. Lesson 1. Introduction to Digital and Physical Archives. Presented by Helen Selsden, AFB Archivist. Helen Selsden appears in mid-range close-up. She has curly, shoulder-length hair and is wearing a red scoop-necked shirt.
Hi, I'm Helen Selsden, the archivist at the American Foundation for the Blind. I'm going to introduce you to digital and physical archival collections and show you how to search and browse the Helen Keller Archive. This archive is a fully accessible digital archive, which means it can be used by people who are blind, deaf, deaf-blind, and hard of hearing, as well as those who can see and hear. This archive is the world's largest collection of materials by and about Helen Keller. Sometimes I'll ask you questions that will prompt you to try something new at home. Pause this video for as long as you need. I'll still be here when you're done. So let's get started. Do you have a collection? Many people do. I have a stamp collection. I've been collecting stamps since I was 7. Personal collections like this are a kind of archive. In its simplest form, archives are collections that you store and organize for later. For example, my stamp collection is organized by country and date. If you took your collection and organized it and then wrote a guide on how to search it, you'd be running your archive like a pro. So, let's define an archive. To be an archive, a collection must be composed of unique documents, objects, and other artifacts, and must be organized to make sense of a collection so that people can find what they're looking for. An archive is sometimes organized by an institution, managed by archivists, and made available to researchers. It can tell us about a person, organization, or physical things. It is typically held and protected in a physical repository, but may be made accessible electronically via a digital platform. Most archives look like this. But as the internet becomes a more important part of our lives, many archives are becoming digital. That means you can access many amazing artifacts and fascinating documents at your fingertips. Take a moment to think about what are the pros and cons of physical and digital archival collections. What can you do in a physical archive that you cannot do in a digital archive, and vice versa? Pause this video to consider your answer. I bet you came up with a lot of great responses. Here are some of ours. In a physical archive, you can have a hands-on encounter with the past. For example, how would it feel to see or read from the original Declaration of Independence at the National Archives in Washington, D.C.? With a physical archive, you can flip through a folder more easily than loading a new page for every document. Unfortunately, most archives are not digitized, so it's still far easier to access many more items by visiting a physical collection. However, there are also many advantages to digital archival collections. Most importantly, they are accessible worldwide on the internet. You don't have to travel to see what's in the archive. Many are also keyword searchable. You can find what you're looking for in exactly the same way as you undertake a regular search on the internet. The digital Helen Keller Archive, as well as other digital collections, have useful transcriptions and metadata often included. I'll illustrate what metadata is shortly. These pieces of information help you understand the 5 W's, who, what, when, where, and why of the artifacts in the archive. Finally, digital archival collections are more accessible to people with disabilities, including those with visual and hearing impairments. For example, the digital Helen Keller Archive allows users to change the text size and text color and provides description for multimedia, including photographs, film, and audio. Right, let's explore the digital Helen Keller Archival Collection. Do you know who Helen Keller was? Take a moment to think about what you've learned about Helen in the past. You probably know her as the child at the water pump, or a sweet old lady, but this is to come away with a very limited understanding of her and what she accomplished. Helen fought for those with vision loss, but she was also a fighter for freedom of speech and the right of every individual to live in dignity. She was born in 1880 and died in 1968. During her long life, she wrote over 14 books and hundreds of essays. She fought for workers' rights, women's rights, and the marginalized. For 44 years, she worked at the American Foundation for the Blind, championing the rights of those with vision loss. She took her fight nationwide and to 39 countries around the globe. Helen Keller led the charge for changes in legislation, rehabilitation, and education to assist those with visual impairments. And very importantly, she changed perceptions of blindness itself. She showed that a woman who is both deaf and blind has the same ability and an equal right to lead a happy and fulfilling life as her sighted and hearing peers. Now I'm going to show you how to use our archive. I'll demonstrate how to browse and search the collection. Then you can try at home. I am using a mouse, so that's how I'll give you the instructions. But this is an accessible archive, so it should work and play well with any assistive technology that you're using. Let's start with browse. To go to the digital archive, go to www.afb.org/Helen Keller Archive. I hope you're there. So, the browse tool is a great way to explore the different types of materials contained in the archive. To start browsing, I go to the Browse tab at the top of the home page. I then hover on the tab and three options appear: browse by series, browse by subject, and browse by tags. I've selected the first option, browse by series. The Helen Keller Archive is arranged by types of material known as series. Series in the Helen Keller Archive include letters, photographs, artifacts, press clippings, and more. I want to find a photograph of Helen and her dogs, so I select Series 7, Photographic Material, and I click on this link. I then choose Subseries 1, Photographs. I again click on this link, and a list of 61 boxes appears. These boxes are arranged by subject in alphabetical order. I am going to choose Box 7, Folder 7. I have chosen the first item. Here we go, Box 7, Folder 7. I am choosing the first item in the folder. This is an image of Helen seated on a bench with a dog. Possibly her pet dog, Sieglinder, who is seated by her feet. He's gorgeous. Scroll down to beneath the image and you will find all the rich information about the image, both the transcription on the left-hand side of the screen here and the metadata on the right. The metadata includes technical and other descriptive information about the image, such as the date the image was taken, the image size, format, photographer where we know it, as well as subjects for this specific digital image. These subjects were selected by metadata assistants to help researchers locate information on a specific topic. In this instance, the subject, animal-dog, was chosen. Now you try. Follow the link again, www.afb.org/Helen Keller Archive. All right. Hover over the Browse tab, choose Browse by Series. So now you see all the 10 series. Can you find an image of a boomerang that was a gift to Helen Keller? A couple of clues here. It is an image of an object. Which of these series contains images of three-dimensional objects? Okay, so select one that you think might contain three-dimensional objects. Okay, the answer is Artifacts, which is Series 8, and I'm clicking on it now. You can pause the video if you need to and come back to the when you found it. Okay, now I'm going to illustrate how to do a simple keyword search. This is a great way to search the archive for topics you are already interested in. Maybe you've heard of the women's suffrage movement. That's when women fought for the right to vote. Helen Keller was a committed supporter of suffrage. So let's find a document related to this topic. I'm going to use the simple term, search term, suffrage. Using the search tab on the main page, I choose simple search. I go to simple search. I do clear search to make sure I'm beginning a completely new search. And then I type in the word suffrage. And I hit search. You see, I have 494 results, it says, under search results for suffrage. But we want to refine that search. I'm interested in the period from 1910 to 1919. So on the left-hand side, I can choose by decade. I'm clicking on 1910 to 1919. I'm clicking on that, and I now have 101 results. Now you try. Follow the link again, www.afb.org/Helen Keller Archive. Go to the search tab, choose simple search, click on the search tab. Clear your search. Then we're going to search for the word pacifism. So type in the word pacifism. Use the left-hand navigation column to refine your search. There are plenty of ways to do this again, by date, by subject, by place, and by person. Pause the video and then come back when you've completed your search. Finally, let's learn to browse by subject. This tool allows you to find material in alphabetical order by topic. To start, go to the Browse tab and select the Browse by Subject option. Okay, an enormous list comes up. And unsurprisingly, blindness is a large category. You'll also find categories such as France, socialism, tuberculosis is extremely lengthy. Feel free to use your controls as follows. For a Mac, use Command plus F, and for a PC, use Control plus F to find your search term. I'm going to use Control plus F, and I'm going to search for the term Buddhism. Control F, Buddhism. And up it comes. And this takes me to religion-Buddhism. Okay, I'm going to click on that term. And here I've got three items come up under that section. Now it's your turn. So follow this link again, www.afb.org/Helen Keller Archive. Hover over the Browse tab, and again, select by subject. So now it's your turn to pick a topic you care about and find out if it's represented in the archive using Command or Control F. Pause the video and then come back when you've completed your search. We hope that your Browse by Subject search was a success and you've discovered even more fascinating items in the Helen Keller Archive. And we hope that you've enjoyed learning how to navigate an online digital collection and learn more about Helen's life and her achievements in the process. And tell others about this resource. And of course, if you've got suggestions or comments, please feel free to contact me, Helen Selsdon, at helselsdon@afb.org. And thank you so much for taking part. Thank you.
Helen Selsdon, archivist, AFB, HSELSDON, at afb.org, 212-502-7628. Copyright 2020, American Foundation for the Blind, all rights reserved. Be sure to visit our websites for more information. Helen Keller Archive at www.afb.org/Helen Keller Archive. American Foundation for the Blind, AFB, Expanding Possibilities for People with Vision Loss. We can be found online at www.afb.org.